آية، فبأي آلاء ربك وتكرم؟ How many of the favors which Allah SWT is giving us forget and to kaziban is to you know think of as falsehood as well. If you look at the word give, to deny it, to not even acknowledge it. First, we have to try to acknowledge that Allah SWT has given us a ni'mah. Unfortunately, we don't acknowledge it in the first place, never mind then appreciate it or try to understand it. And if we deny His favors, then every single favor we will be accountable for. And if we express our gratitude for the favors which Allah SWT has given us, then at least I believe we are somewhere in at least being safe from His wrath. And at least that ni'mat will stay with us a little bit longer. But again, because of the favors Allah SWT has given us, and we've not expressed our true gratitude to them, then these things will be taken away one by one. And why do we need that to happen to us for us to then reflect? Because if Allah SWT wants us to remember Him, then isn't it better we remember Him when He gives us something, rather than remember Him when He takes something away? So it's better that whenever Allah SWT is giving us anything, is to do shukr. Say Alhamdulillah, you know, that you give us this. Even if we sat here all night and said Alhamdulillah, we still would not fulfill what Allah SWT has given us, you know. Once we understand what Allah SWT has given us first, then there'll be a sense of appreciation. When there's a sense of appreciation, then we're understanding our true ubudiyah, our true slavery, as to true how much of a master Allah SWT is and how great He is. And this in itself, to you know, why do we say Allahu Akbar? You know, we say these Arabic words, but what are we saying? Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest. You know, what do we mean by that? Greatest in what? So we need to kind of ponder and reflect over the language that we use, the verses that we recite, and just pause a little bit. Okay, you don't need to take a 3.5 hour drive in the rain, or even a 5 minute sit down in the masjid, just to ponder for those minutes and say, Ya Allah, I have been blind and dumb and unappreciative for what You've given me. I recognize now what You've given me. It's like a child who's 17, 18, 19 years old, and his father or mother asks him to do something, and the child turns and says, what have you ever done for me? What have you ever done for me? And that mother looks at him. It's the same thing here, isn't it? The father looks at him like, what are you talking about? In the same way, how are we any different when it comes to Allah SWT?